Yes, what does it mean that one would give, turn over, or surrender his life to Jesus? There are two topics that comprise this motivation. The first motivation is the drive to righteousness and popularity. Drive to righteousness comes out of several different things that we begin to idealize what Jesus' righteousness is. And that's usually done by the age of 9 years old. So we look back at the younger life of the individual at 9 years old and we decide to baptize. The adult baptisms begin at about the age of 9. Now, if we remove the baptism and place it only on infancy, then the idea of the structural deisms to give to the person has to be in the lesser. But for baptizing later, the more instruction you need to give. Now that's the way baptism was proven in our home. My brother was baptized as a baby, and he required less instruction. He was the older one, but my dad waited to baptize me until I was 8 or 9 years old. And that's the fact of righteousness. That's how righteousness gets imparted. And once it's imparted, then we look for a response to understand the person's righteousness and guide them towards the evidences of their responses to the correct beneficial field of use. And that happens in about 10 to 14 stages throughout one's life. But you have to realize that Jesus prepared for ministry each and every time. He would go out and he would prepare. So while you're in ministry or in beneficial position, you must prepare for your other positions that are coming up in the future by the elements of not resting and study. Now, prayer is a thing, but it seems to be a thing of the past, and that's a good thing. Prayer usually distracts and distorts idealisms, and the only real benefit of prayer is the usage of prayer in sports, where we're praying and then manufacturing the courage and making the connection. Prayer in sports is really the only true dynamic of prayer for the young individual, and then when we're older, to prayer in the military. So that's the first aspect. We go out seeking righteousness.